Hiya. Colin Davies here. In these troubled times when we're spending a lot of time at home, and quite rightly too, stay at home, stay safe, save lives. I thought I would do a tutorial on an old, well-known James Taylor song called You Can Close Your Eyes. So I'll start and I'll just go through, I'll play through the song so you've got it in context. And then we'll break it down section by section, and I'll show you all the fingering and the left hand work and everything. Okay, so this is the song. Well, the sun is surely sinking down, and the moon is slowly rising. So this old world must still be spinning round, and I still love you. So close your eyes, you can close your eyes, it's alright. I don't know no love songs, I can't sing the blues anymore. I can sing this song, you can sing this song when I'm gone. It won't be long before another day, we're gonna have a good time, and no one's gonna take that time away. You can stay as long as you like. So close your eyes, you can close your eyes, it's alright. I don't know no love songs, I can't sing the blues anymore. But I can sing this song, you can sing this song. I'm gone. Okay, let's break the song down then. First thing to say is the capo is on the second fret. The song is in the key of E major, but with the capo on, effectively, that's going to make it in the key of D major. So when I refer to chords, I'll be referring to chords as though we're in D major without a capo. Okay, so that let's look at the intro first. I'll just play it slowly. Now, a key thing about this is this third finger here on the third, on effectively the D, I'm going to call this the D, the third fret of the B string. That's the anchor. That stays there, all except for one note, that stays there for the whole of the intro. So it acts as the anchor for moving the other fingers around, which is a very efficient, clean way of playing. So it's, do it very slowly. So that's A. And then the two D's. So that's the opening riff. That's the next chord, which is a G major but with a B bass. And I'm only playing strings 2, 4, 5 and 6. I'm not playing this this D string here, the third string, the fourth string. So that's still strings 2, 4, 5, and 6, and you we're changing from, just lift those two fingers off, because you're not playing the D string, that's not going to be discordant. And then that D goes down to the C sharp, which is the only time it comes off this fret. Repeat. There's a little extra hammer on there. And then we switch to playing strings 1, 4, 5, 6. So the whole riff is... down to the E. A little arpeggio there on 2, 4, 5 and 7. So the whole intro then, slowly. Okay, so that's the intro. Now let's just go through the verse slowly. Right, I'll stop there. Slower. So, and then the next part of the verse is possibly the most difficult part. It's a very easy, the next chord very easy, it's an E minor 7th without any fingers on the left hand at all. And it's strings 1, 3, 4, 5. And we're using Travis picking here, so 1, 4, 2, 3. So it's... And then it's a B minor. Now that's quite a difficult change, but there are ways to make it slightly easier. The fact that we're Travis picking means that when we get to that B minor, the first note that plays is the B on its own. So that gives us a little bit more time to get the other fingers in position. And the next note after the B is the D. So you can concentrate on getting those strings fretted, because they're the ones you're playing first. Also, don't worry about the top string, you're not going to play that, so. Then it's an A on strings 2, 3, 4, 5. G. Once again, slowly. I think I played that slightly differently there. Okay, the next bit is not as tricky as it sounds, I don't think, anyway. So, I'll just play up to it if I may. Sounds great. It's not that difficult to play really once you know what you're doing. So as you come off the A major, you've got that little feature. And then we go, and this is it, basically playing strings 1 and 5, 1 and 4, 1 and 4. But you're doing an alternate picking. Whoops. If you play the bottom G with the third finger, you may want to use your thumb to play that bottom F sharp. I can't bend my left thumb, so I can't do that. Right, now from that bass note, you go straight to this F sharp. Beautiful chord work. Good old James. Then we're back into the D. And this time we go to the D. Okay, the next section, I just need to lead into it. The next section is, you go from that D to a G. I'm not playing the A string there. So that's a G. These strings are like a drone up here. E note on the bass, A note. So, from the coming out of the verse, I'll do the whole verse just for context. Well, the sun is shining, and the moon is slowly rising. So this old world must still be spinning, and I still love. And then we're into the chorus. Okay, so chorus. So close your eyes. So that's G. I'm not playing the B string again. Sorry, the A string. So that's, when you break it down, it's pretty straightforward. These three notes are played all the way through, except for that move down to the C sharp there. Then you play the C and the G, then to that B minor. That's probably the most difficult change. But you have the advantage that, you know, because of the Travis picking, you can actually play that B note, bass B note first. So. That little hammer on the D to the D there, right? And then that's that first chord is actually that, so B added ninth. I think that's a real signature part of the whole guitar work on this song, so you really need to know that. E minor seventh. I don't know. I don't know love songs. C. There's a little run, so E7th, I've got the little finger there on the D string, but I can sing that song, and then we go to an open G. And that's like arpeggios, at least the way I play it. But I can sing this song. Just do a little. And you can sing this song. Up to the A, 7 suspended. And then that B minor again. So it features a lot, that. You really need to know that. But I can sing this song, and you can sing this song when I'm gone. And then there's a little instrumentally bit which finishes the chorus and also finishes the whole song. And it's a similar little run till you get to there. Quick, using the A bass, play the D chord, A7 actually, so, again, that little musically bit at the end. We're gonna have a good time. And no one's gonna take that time away. Right, now he does something different there, and it's a little riff that he uses in quite a few songs. So on the second part of that second verse, and no one's gonna take that time away. Normally, in the, all the other cases, you do this. He does something slightly different. So, let me explain that. So, A, E, top E, open, let that ring. Go from, and that's it's like an E major with an A bass, or A major ninth probably. So that's A, E, G sharp, open B. And then he hammers on both. Strings 4 and 5. So you need to let that top E ring, it sounds very nice. But he still does the little up to the just go through that second verse again. Won't be long before another day. We're gonna have a good time. And no one's gonna take that time away. Time. You can stay as long as you like. So close your eyes. You can close your eyes. So I don't know no love songs. I can't sing the blues anymore. But I can sing this song. You can sing this song when I'm gone. So the outro is almost identical to the intro, except it resolves to the D at the end. I'll slow it down now.